ABC Friday. It's a night of changes on TGIF. First, will Eddie change his mind about marrying Myrtle Urkel?
Let's just leave that down for a while.
Family Matters. Then, these guys have become national champs of a quiz show.
And these pouty lips have made me a star.
An all-new Boy Meets World. And Sabrina enters a cat show, and she's the cat. A perfect all-new Sabrina.
Another hairball.
Man, ooh la la. Does this hot French model really want to marry JT?
Married.
And all new Step by Step, where things are changing on TGIF ABC Friday.
When he needed a place to hide, an all-girl school seemed perfect.
Aren't gonna be.
Mr. Headmistress, ABC Tonight at 7, 6 Central.
I'm telling you, Tucker, this one definitely belongs on your prison highlight reel.
Yeah, well, you'd be amazed what you can do with some kitchenware and a mail-order degree in engineering. Come on, $10.
$10? You just said $5.
Well, ringside, you gotta pay for it. Let's go. Come on. That's it. There we go. Hot dogs. Who needs a hot $5 for this fight? Thanks, Eddie. Hot dogs. Hot dogs.
Hey, man, give me one.
$10
for a hot dog. Thank you. Make it 20
for you. Hot dog. Highway robbery, man.
Tell me, how'd you make out?
Like a couple of high school kids on prom night.
Great. Chuck, ain't you worried the warden's gonna find out about your fight scam a week before you're getting out?
Kaminsky, I'm more worried that those guys are gonna find out that the networks are running the fight for free.
Here they are, boss. Read them and weep.
Yeah. Cutie pie? You do know these are for stolen cars, right, Caesar?
Yeah, but this gives it a more personal touch, don't you think?
Wait a minute. How do we know we're going to get our cut once you get sprung?
Hey, hey, fellas, have a little faith here, huh? I'm a con man, not a thief. Trust me.
Mm-hmm.
This is the kind of scam that gets you a lot of respect out on the street.
Do you spell lovey lips with a Y or with an E?
You know, I'd like to take you out to lunch, but you're already there, aren't you?
Thanks, man.
Come in.
You wanted to see me, sir?
Yes, I did. Have a seat. I want to talk to you about your release.
Nice handiwork.
Well, it keeps my stationery in line. Look, Tucker, you are a bright, industrious young man. Why do you insist on being such an incorrigible delinquent?
With all due respect, sir, during my incarceration here, I did manage to earn 8 diplomas.
All which have the line, fill in name here. You know, it's amazing how you resist my 3 proven methods of reform, you know? Incentive before discipline, always lead by example, and most importantly,
Milk and cookies before nap time?
No, always be yourself.
Well, in that case, I guess we'll be seeing each other real soon, right, Warden?
You know, Tucker, we tend to label people in this world, but if there's one thing I've learned, people buy the product, not the label.
Well, I'll try to remember that, sir. So long.
My paperweight?
Yeah.
Nice try.
Hey, come on, you guys. These aren't the clothes I was arrested in.
Sorry, Tucker, but that's all we got. At least until the new fall line gets in.
Haven't I already paid my debt to society?
Oh, your pen. Your pen, Tucker.
Hit the road, Tucker.
Nice dress, buddy.
Shut up and throw these in the car.
Man, what you got in here? Your mood ring collection?
No, our next big haul. Now, the way I see it, if we use these plates and we sell them to Larry, we're gonna make a killing.
Hey, relax. I have you taken care of already. I called my guy down at DMV.
DMV?
Yeah.
You offered to sell the guy at the DMV fake plates that we're gonna put on stolen cars?
I think so. Well, if you didn't want me to, then I didn't. I mean, you know, maybe I did. What do you want? I'm trying to remember now.
It's quiet time for you now. In the car. Driving.
I don't know you anymore.
Quiet time.
Okay, anything else here?
See, and on top of that, I got to design a pill. Instead of, you know, Fin-Fin, I had a pill called Win-Win. When am I gonna lose weight?
What'll it be, boys?
Of the surf and turf.
Sir, you're gonna have to take a rain check on the surf. We're all out of lobster. Just sold my last two.
Oh, give me the shrimp.
Net's empty on that one, too. And while you're at it, no crab, no scallops, oysters, or mussels.
Well, now, seeing how ostensibly this is a seafood establishment, is there anything here that at one point in time actually swam in the ocean?
Well, I've been known to snorkel.
I'll take the chicken.
Mm-hmm. How about you, sailor?
Y'all got ribs? Chicken?
Okay, two cluckin' turfs coming right up. Two cluckin' turfs!
Sorry, out of cluckin' turfs.
No cluckin' turfs.
How fast can you run in those platform shoes?
Why?
Because I think two of our old friends just showed up.
Oh, boy, looks like Farley and Granger just got the last two lobsters.
Well, well, if it isn't our former business associate.
Hey, guys, we were just looking for y'all.
Let me guess, some guys find salvation in prison. You found David Cassidy?
Very funny. Speaking of fashion, you guys should wear the bibs more often. It takes the focus off your lack of neck.
Listen, about the 50 large you still owe us, we'd rather it not accrue any more interest if you follow my drift.
Okay. Fellas, no need to drool all over your bibs here. I mean, I'm sure we can find a fair and equitable solution to this little problem.
Tell them about the plates. Tell them about the plates.
What plates?
Gentlemen, you are looking at easily 50 grand of untraceable plates.
Plus, we got the DMV in our hip pocket.
Lovely lips, huh?
I'm gonna spill the wine.
All right, let's save the spell check for later, huh, Chungles? Now, what do you say?
I say we show you what's in our trunk.
Yeah.
Come on, come over.
Hey, 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 you ain't got to grab right on the trunk.
Put him down.
Take a good whiff of those fish over there, Tucker, because you're going to be swimming with them real soon.
Hold it. You guys forgot to pay your tab.
I'll get that. Sorry.
Hey, where do you think you're going, Superfly?
Hey, next one's on me, boy.
You know, he just went to the disco
right
quick. He like to dance.
How did anyone ever learn to do the hustle in these things?
He's right there. Come on.
Whoa.
Move it. There he is. Right there.
Where did we go through?
Right there.
Did you see a guy in bell bottoms and platform shoes just run by here?
Yeah, and he was being chased by a construction worker, a cop, and a guy wearing an Indian headdress and singing YMCA.
There
it
is!
Cut!
I don't know. Oh.
Departing in 15 minutes on track. Four train for Rockwater.
Yeah, 1970's coming through. Never dressed like this kid. Excuse me.
Mind that bag, young man.
Ma'am?
One day you will learn that a job well done is its own reward.
Dressed person on this train until now.
How dare you invade my space like this? I took great pains to ensure a private compartment.
Lady, something tells me that your mere presence would ensure a private compartment.
Get out of here this instant, or I'll summon the authorities.
Hey, you don't need to scare them, too. See ya. Good idea.
I'm going to scream.
No, lady, don't do that.
Sorry.
Hi.
Sorry.
How dare you invade my space like this? I went to great pains to ensure a private compartment.
Sorry, we were looking for a friend of ours.
Now arriving in Rockwater.
Oh, at last, we're here in Merry Merry Rockwater.
Granger, come on, move. Get out of her way.
You Wally Winkle. Goodbye. Ta-ta. Ta-ta to you too.
Naomi Bascom. So, the nightmare has a name.
Miss Bascom. Miss Bascom.
Whoa. I've come to pick you up, Miss Bascom.
Bascom?
Bascom.
That would be me?
Yes, hey. I'm Donald Ferguson. I'm your biggest fan. Oh. I can't tell you what a pleasure it is to finally meet you. Although I must say, you look completely different than the picture on your book cover. It's almost like a different person.
The books?
Yes.
Yes, royalties and all. I've had a little nip and tuck. I feel 20 years younger.
You look really good. You look good.
There she is. Come on.
You don't happen to know where a travel-weary woman could get a getaway car, do you? Or a ride?
Yes, I have my car right in the park. I've got your bag.
What did you call me?
Final call for the train for Crawleyville, calling at Chester Hall, Mount Havenhurst, and Ashbury on track 3. All aboard, please.
Your accent is charming. Is it Welsh?
Yes, actually. My father was a Welsh corgi.
Welsh corgi. Isn't that a dog?
Well, as good a description as any for the old latcher, you know. Now, don't you think we should be on our way?
Order in the window!
Never mind them, just a couple of ne'er-do-wells who are pestering me on the
roll
train.
Roll down the window!
Ooh, they want me to roll down the window.
Yeah, I'm sure they want many naughty things. Now, let's go, please.
No, I'm going down the window!
Aren't you forgetting something? Your purse. I left it on the train, lady.
Well, as they say in Chuckles, Princeton, ta-ta, and meet me.
Miss Bascom.
Goodness. How long was I out?
20 minutes. We're almost there.
There? Where would there be?
Where would there be what?
I get it.
It's one of your rhyming drills. Having fun with language. Crawford University Press, first printing, 1981. I know everything there is to know about Naomi Bascom.
Yes,
I'm sure. Glad somebody around here does.
Oh, here's the school.
The school?
Beautiful, impressive. Sorry about the sign.
The sign?
Yeah, the girls seem to be defacing it. But that will all change now that you're here. Right, Miss Headmistress?
Right. Headmistress!
What? Oh, come on, Carlotta. Daddy's not there. 2 weeks running? You know, Carlotta, even by the standards of an evil stepmother, you stink. Do you know that?
One more infraction, Miss Andrews, and your father will receive a lengthy note from my office.
Yeah, well, if you can find him, tell him his only daughter sends her regards. You know, first order of business after we get rid of this new headmistress, new dirty Harriet.
Speaking of which, who do you think they got to replace our last victim?
I don't know. But whoever she is, she better have a killer health plan.
Welcome to Rawlings Academy.
No.
Now, there's no need to be nervous, Miss Bascom. The girls have prepared a wonderful welcome for you.
Yes. I see. Tell me, is the gate left unlocked at night?
Now, looking ahead just a few days, two reporters from the Daily Journal are going to come here to do a piece on you. I've taken the liberty of filling them in on some of the highlights of your career.
Yes, and what a brilliant career it's been.
Miss Bascom, you can't. No, you can't leave yet. I need to schedule an appointment with you and Mr. Rawlings to discuss the donation.
Yes, well, excuse me, does that road lead to a main highway? Because. Donation?
Yes, the $500,000 he keeps promising us. Well, not us, not you and me, but the school. Only you and I, as financial officer, could sign for it, though.
500 G's? Dollars?
Yes, unfortunately, it's been an empty promise so far. No headmistress has been able to wrangle any money out of him yet.
Well, I assure you, Mr. Ferguson, I am no ordinary headmistress. Now, what do you say we be off and meet those delightful girls?
Yes.
Now, if everything goes according to plan, our Ms. Bathscum will be out of here in the next 24 hours.
Which, by my estimates, would be a new Rawlings record.
Yes.
Ladies? Settle, please.
There's so many of them.
That's perfect.
Yes, after you.
No, after you.
No, please.
After me.
Yes.
Shh. Hello, girls. Hello.
I'm sensing a certain deep-seated inadequacy here. All the better to terrorize, girls. All the better to terrorize.
Oh, yeah.
500 G's. 500 G's.
3, 2, 1.
To Rawlings, Headmistress.
Ms. Bascom, are you okay? I am so sorry that happened.
Yes, well, I'm used to a lot of hijinks where I come from.
Delightful girls, aren't they?
Yes. And who might this bright little sunflower be?
Our athletic director and resident student rights activist, Sally Jeffries.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Miss Bascom. If there's anything I can do to help ease your transition here, please don't hesitate to ask.
Yummy. Well, what a firm grip you have, darling.
Not nearly as firm as yours, Miss Bascom.
Years of dunking crumpets can do wonders for one's wrist muscles, can't they? Oh, look at this.
Well, everybody, I think it's time for Miss Bascom's speech. Are you all right?
Yes, just clearing out the old lung muscles, you know.
Yes, the Bascom oratorical exercises. I read about that. They're famous. Strange.
Please, Miss Bascom, we're all ears.
Yes, please.
Ears, yes. Well, I see before me a sea of faces. Schoolgirls' faces. Faces that will one day no longer be schoolgirls' faces. Well, they'll still be your faces, but they'll no longer be in school. Or at least I hope not. As your headmistress, I intend to instruct you in the three R's essential to any girl's good education. Reading, writing, and accessorizing. Because looking your best is what being a woman is all about, isn't it? Hair and makeup, girls, hair and makeup.
Did she just do what I think she did? So, she did she?
In conclusion,
oh, she did.
Just keep your noses clean, and the rest of your face will follow. Thank you, and ta-ta.
Thumbtack, simple, but effective.
Well, after what the girls did to you today, watch it. After what they did to you today, I'm sure that Miss Magnum will probably restrict them to their rooms.
Oh, lockup. Those are always tough.
Yeah. Our Miss Magnum runs a very tight ship.
Let's say, this place makes the joint look like the Ritz.
Personally, I'm really glad that they passed her over for the job of Miss Headmistress and gave it to you instead. Not to put any pressure on you, Miss Bascom, but we're counting on you to get this school back on track after our last headmistress.
Last headmistress, what?
No. It's nothing. The doctor said that after reconstructive surgery and the swelling goes down, she'll be up and about in no time. Here we are. Here's your room. Come this way. Here it is. This is your suite.
Sweet. It looks more like bittersweet, doesn't it?
It's a little cold. I'll just close that window.
Yes. Regular Buckingham Palace in here, isn't it?
Warm up. It'll be toasty in no time. Oh, we'll just fix that up when the donation comes in.
Oh, the donation, yes. I'd completely forgotten about it.
Well, a few pictures, maybe a lamp. It'll really liven up the place. If there's anything else I could do for you.
Oh, yes, how about a first-class plane ticket to Hawaii?
I love a good luau, don't you?
Yes, I'm really a disturbing little freak.
Way to go, Tucker. Really done it this time. Wearing a dress. Let's see this. Stupid. Girdle, for crying out loud. Shoes.
Oh, it's so dark. Help, light bulb down. SOS, hello.
How dare Rawlings pass me over for that job? And after everything I've accomplished for these girls.
And all without corporal punishment.
I created the most elaborate code of conduct since Napoleonic law. And who does he choose over me? Some highbrow, pompous snoot who wants to bring these girls some outdated British notion of academic excellence.
We have to prove that you're the right woman for the job.
That's simple. We'll just prove that our Ms. Bascom is not.
Come on, pay up. TV, okay. Love pizza, money. Thank you very much. All right, give me
what?
Money. Give me my money. Thank you very much. You know what the deal is. TV, pizza, money. Thank you very much.
Hey, Beryl, I'm a little short on cash. You think you can spot me till my next moneygram?
No, you know the rules. There's no credit. After this is over,
you're history.
Yeah, well, if Dirty Harriet finds out about your TV, so are you.
Beryl, you are really lucky your dad sent you a TV.
Yeah, well, at this point, I'd settle for a postcard.
House of Beauty, this is Cutie.
Hey, Jim.
It's Tucker.
Hey, Tuck, where are you, man? I've been worried about you. You all right?
I can't hear you.
What happened with the
those clowns, Farley and Granger. Did you get away?
Hang on, let me take off my hair.
I'm dressed as a school headmistress.
You're dressed as a what?
Just relax.
Tuck, is this a cry for help, man?
Listen to me, there's a half million here with our names on it. Some old fogey's gonna make a donation to the school. All I gotta do is play headmistress for a few days.
This'll be our next big haul. Trust me.
Tuck, you're talking about running the school here, man. That's not exactly your thing.
You haven't seen this place. It looks more like a prison. If there's one thing I know how to run, my friend, it's a prison. Now, take this down. I'm gonna need some supplies.
Shoot.
Some hairspray, some lavender pumps.
Lavender pumps?
Hey, it's my color.
See those bright, shiny faces.
Ms. Baskin, it's the men's room.
Oh, yes, of course it is, darling. There's never anyone in there. I like to tinkle privately, you know. So, how are things going with our fearless field hockey team?
Well, I guess it's about as good as can be expected for a school with no team spirit. Ms. Baskin? Telling the girls that they're only as good as their latest makeover is really not the kind of positive reinforcement they need right now.
Now, Miss Jeff.
It's Ms., if you don't mind. Now, I'm late for the faculty meeting.
Where no man has gone before.
Now, as we all know, Regulation 652A clearly states no hemline shall exceed 3 inches above the knee. Please see to it that the girls comply.
Thank you, Miss Magnum. Now, the next order of business. Midterms.
Our test results last semester single-handedly lowered the state's literacy rate.
Give it a break. These girls aren't stupid. They're just unmotivated.
Unmotivated? They're one step away from reform school.
Of course, if you had your way, you'd turn this place into a reform school.
All right, ladies. May I again remind you that Mr. Rawlings' donation is directly contingent upon the improvement of the girls' grades.
Grades?
House of Beauty, this is Cutie.
Jim, I'm in trouble here.
Check this out, man. Listen.
I was thinking, why don't we fence these plates to kids, you know, for their bikes?
No. Forget the license plates, all right? I got 2 days to get those little monsters' grades up, or it's goodbye donation, adios cash, goodnight lettuce.
Well, you got 8 diplomas. Why don't you just teach them?
Hey, you're right. How hard could it be?
No. Don't forget about the license plate idea, because we can miniaturize them. See, I got an uncle in the cereal business, right? All we can do is we can put them in the boxes. The
kids would
love it.
Jim?
They would love it, man. Now, hey, don't put me on hold for long. You know my time is money.
Cute girls. Very cute.
I'm still here. Oh! Ideas!
Jim.
What's up?
I'm in serious trouble here.
My little angels.
An apple for the teacher.
Think to the right, people to the left, over the shoulder. All that. Now, let's make something perfectly straight. I have a very personal interest in all your girls' grades. So until the midterms this Friday, I'm taking a hands-on approach to your studies. Do I make myself clear?
Clear as a bell, Ms. Bascom.
Ah, the wonderful world of science. Today we'll be looking at chemistry, because chemistry makes us be more in touch with our chemical things. Let's start with chemical equilibrium, shall we? Very often, the conditions under which a reaction takes place are conditions under which the reverse also can occur. So, keeping that in mind, let's put on our safety glasses And we'll start with the chemical known as, well, green. Known as G-R-E-E-N. Ooh, and let's try a little bit of this one. A popular one, pink, as we know it. P-I-N-K square. And then finally, our final little compound here, known as titus nucleoxide. I guess what we've learned today is that when some things are put together, they just don't mix, do they, Beryl?
Toast to Beryl, shall we?
Slayer of Headmistresses.
Liberator of Schoolgirls.
Best group of girls.
Thank you very much, but you stole me $10.
Cheers, ladies.
Bottom up, girls. Who is it?
It's your illustrious headmistress.
Wait, I got it. Some of this TV, quick.
Hurry, just hurry.
All right. We let her out of the infirmary already?
I'm a quick heel. What are you hiding there, child?
Nothing.
What's this I see? Contraband of the Italian-American variety, perhaps?
That's our pizza.
Still warm.
Yeah, well, don't worry. It's our last pizza. Dirty Harriet cut off our supply.
What's that I smell? Cream? Crinkly? Unmarked? Well.
How did you know? I don't know.
Let's just call it a headmistress's intuition, shall we? Now, here's my offer to you girls. Hypothetically speaking, if you were able to bring your grades up just a tillywinkle, what might I offer you in return?
Is this a bribe?
Let's just call it more of an educational incentive, shall we?
It's a joke.
Mm-hmm. As someone at my former institution once said, incentive before discipline.
Well, now that you mention it, there's something that we want.
What? An end to revel, perhaps?
Nah, we don't sleep anyway. We want a party. We want a big party.
With boys.
Cute boys.
Lonely boys.
Any boys. We want a full-out rave.
With DJs.
Lights and
blasting music.
That's it? Oh, well, that shouldn't be too difficult, should it?
You try finding a boys' school, it'll come within a country mile of this place. It is so sad.
Yes, well, just watch me, and I'll put this money towards the Twinkies and Punch.
Oh, man.
That's our money.
Oh, there it goes. There it goes. That's all. Come and get it if you dare.
The Wonderful World of Disney will continue in a moment, here on ABC.